Welcome to part 6 of our GarageBand tutorials. These tutorials cover version 10 of GarageBand. If you go to my channel and look at the playlists, I do have a playlist set up for previous versions of GarageBand as well. But as long as you're using version 10, this should cover it. In this episode 6, we're going to discuss how to create a software instrument track in your GarageBand project. You can see on the screen that we already have a little bit of the project going. If you're not sure how we got to this point, you can go back to this playlist and watch the previous videos, and that should get you there. So to start with, we need to talk about what a software instrument is. A software instrument is an actual instrument that's built into GarageBand. It's a synthetic instrument. It can sound like a guitar. It can sound like a piano, string instruments of various types, drum sounds, different things like that. So we're going to talk about how to add that type of instrument in. And this is for the musician who doesn't necessarily even know how to play an instrument. You can go through and add your own instruments, play your own instruments, and learn how to arrange music. So here we go. Next, first thing we'll need to do is create the track. So we come up here and we click on this plus sign, and that will create a track. Or exactly the same thing happens if you come up to track and then click on new track. Either way, you're going to get to where you need to go. This window opens up, and we've seen this before in our previous episodes. I believe it was episode 2 we saw this. Here we are. It asks if we want to create a microphone track or hook an instrument up or have the drums play if we want to do that. But we want to click on this one, which is a picture of an electronic keyboard there. And that's called a software instrument track. All we have to do there is click create. And that brings up a new track. Now, in this case, it brought the track up right in between our previous two tracks. If you'd prefer to keep it in a different order, all you have to do is click and hold and drag the track where you'd like it to go. Now that we've got this track, we can look over at the side, and you can see that there's all sorts of instruments listed here. Now, these may change depending on the version of GarageBand that you have. If you've had previous versions of GarageBand installed, you might see one down here called Legacy. And what that is it's the previous instruments from previous versions of GarageBand that are all in there too. If this is the first time you've installed GarageBand, then you probably will just see this list right here. And like I said, even those can vary a little bit. So we're going to start off with, if we go in here and we click on piano, it's going to give us the option of a Steinway grand piano. So we'll click on that. And now that we've picked that piano, what do we do with it? We know we want to create a track. We know that we want to play the music, but you don't really see anything here. Unless your GarageBand is configured, you might have seen a window come up. But if not, you need to know how to play that instrument. So come up here to the top and click on Window. And then click either on Show Keyboard or Show Musical Typing. You can also, as you can see right here, there's a little shortcut key. You can hold down Command and hit the K key, and it will get you to the same thing. So when I click on Command K or click on Show Musical Typing, it comes up with a keyboard here. Now this keyboard represents the keys, of course, believe it or not, on your keyboard. So if I hit a note, so you can actually play the songs with your keyboard. Now, you only have this one set of, whether it's an octave, I don't play music, but you only have this one narrow part of the keyboard in there. If you want to, you can adjust the octave and move it up and down the keyboard by clicking on this plus and minus key, and you can see this blue region. You can also click and hold and drag on it, depending on whether you want to play at the high end or the low end of the keyboard. Or if you'd like all 88 keys, you do have the option of clicking on the entire keyboard. And I guess we still don't have all 88 keys, but we certainly have more octaves to play with here. We can still slide it up and down to play if we want some super low notes or super high notes. And then from here, it's a small keyboard, but it works. So now we could go through and pick out the various keys that we want. If you want to play a different instrument, you can come over to guitar. You can click on hard rock or classical acoustic, whatever we'd like to pick. Let's go ahead and pick on hard rock. Now if I play these, you've got some notes there. Drag it down on the octaves. and you've got that. So that gives you a test to see what the different instruments sound like, but you still haven't recorded anything yet. You're not ready to go. So before I get started, it depends on whether you want the music to blend in with what you're doing or whether you just want to create a background track of music on how you go forward from here. If you want to be able to hear your entire track, then you would just begin by clicking play. And then you can click record.
My name's Adam Cochran.
And then we can play our instrument. Now, as you can see, that's a little bit obnoxious and it's very difficult to hear what you're doing. So I'm going to show you a couple other options that you have here. So let's go ahead and delete that track. And now I don't want to have all of that stuff going on at the same time. So I'm going to come over and just click on the headphones on my hard rock guitar track. You'll notice that the other tracks all went gray. And that means that as I play this track, I'm only going to hear the notes I play and everything else will be muted. So we'll hit record. And now I'll play. Okay, that was really good. There's our notes. Now we've got this track all recorded. I can go back and listen to it. Okay, you get the idea. Now, if I decide later, oh, you know what? That's not really what I want. Maybe I did want a different type of instrument in there. Let's go into an orchestral instrument. Let's go to our woodwinds and let's hear a clarinet solo. I'm going to go back and play the same thing. All right, so now we have a nice clarinet solo there in the background. It's all recorded. A few other things you can do with this that are kind of fun. You'll notice at the bottom of your screen, if it doesn't show up, you may need to double click on your track right here. So if you double click on it, you'll see at the bottom of your screen, I don't know if you've ever seen Close Encounters, but this thing that looks a little bit like the grid that they play at Close Encounters at the end of the movie. But you have this little grid here with these different notes. These are the notes that you're playing. So unlike the waveform, if I want to edit this track and make it so certain parts are longer or shorter, I can actually just click and hold and drag and even move around the different notes. Just playing with this, it's probably going to sound terrible, but that's okay. I moved around some tracks. We have a lot going on there. Now, if I go back and play it, this is what I have. Okay. So there's my nice little background track. Now, if I turn my headphones off and I move back over, you're going to see that this still doesn't sound terrific, but that doesn't really matter. We're just listening to the layers of tracks piled on top of each other.
My name's Adam Cochran. I'm an instructor of mass communication at Colorado Mesa University. Thank you very much for joining this program.
All right, so we can take that and let's actually have it end after I talk. So let's go right there. And we'll hear how it sounds towards the end.
Colorado Mesa University, thank you very much for joining this program.
All right, so that's not beautiful, it's not terrific, but you get the idea of what happens there. And so that ends episode 6 of this GarageBand 10 tutorial. In our next episode, we will talk about how to add a loops track to your GarageBand project, which is similar to what you'd add with the background music there, but it's another way of doing it, and it adds a little bit more of a baseline to everything, and we'll talk about that as we go. So this has been episode 6 of this GarageBand tutorial.